say, man, this is salvation for the most part. It's easy. Have faith. Pray the Lord and love Him with all thy heart and soul.
Be a brother to your brother. Turn thee, O Jacob, and take hold of me. Walk in the presence of the light thereof, that thou mayest be illuminated. Give not thy honor to another, nor the things that are profitable unto thee to a strange nation. And it's the point. O Israel, happy are we, for things that are pleasing unto you, how are made known unto us.
Conversations instantly just vex me. And the things I say vex you. listens. So I'm doing everybody a favor, and I told them, I'm going out there. Things you say will vex me, and things I say will vex you. And I have, my tolerance is starting to grow thin, dealing with the world and shit. I can't really talk to them. Even when I go around my family, my mother and them, like you said, the time limit, I'm going to take something. Love you all, yeah, it's all good, but eventually you're going to start talking stupid. Women and they lack reason.
Yeah, they should already know what you believe by now. You know? Yeah, it's really nothing to argue about. I ain't saying like you argue with that. I'm saying like speaking in general.
It just lack reason. Yeah. You're talking about potential future and they just, oh, that's not gonna happen. I ain't worried about that. And you like, hold up.
Yeah, hey, if they still argue with you, they pretty much just show how scared they are, is how much they're not willing to humble themselves to what the opposite is.
Yeah. I'm getting tired of it. I gotta deal with people dealing with me. You know, if you can pretend to manage with them for that long, right. I've been sleeping for so long.
Always your damn enemy. You know, most of us come from broken homes where envy and strife. Okay? The scriptures talk about better it is where love is than a stalled ox. Upside down. Now the woman is the head of the household, and the man is the submissive one. You know, oh baby, can I borrow your car? Oh baby, can you give me this money to buy that PS5? You know, the damn PS5 came out. You had all type of memes. You know, niggas. You know, some of the shit was funny. I ain't gonna lie. Yeah, it was niggas in there.
I think I had a question.
Oh, I'm
hold on for a second.
Yeah, you you had people in there that was standing behind a girl in line, like this the pose I'm gonna get, you know, for my girl, she bought my PS5. Yeah, that's what Jake introduced to, Jake introduced to damn baby girl. Alright?
Y'all saw his hell. Placing his hell.
That's right, yeah. Yeah, he don't know himself. He lack patience, all that. Alright?
It's our history, man.
today will be called black.
Oh yeah, I let the haters hate and love and love.
And we're Negro and all that. And we are got, we got to understand who the power is and come from. Because the reason we got that spirit in us is because we're Israelites. When you read this scripture, Jacob, that's who the father is, his name, he was changed to Israel.
Try to help people, even though cigarettes ain't no good help to help them, but they content with it. It's just live like a tree.
Okay, I got you. Now that's optional. However, according to the Bible, there is a dietary law. So there is a life, most times, set up in the nation on the earth. We have holiness. We have unholiness. It makes the game of the live. Which I mean is free. Now that which is clean is just free game. To be a vegetarian, if you want, or whatever. But there are meats in there that are clean. Chicken.
Look, I ain't gonna be great. I stopped eating meat and I started gaining weight. I feel better than I ever felt.
Okay, well, that's good. I mean, like I said, you can have whatever diet you have. If it's in the scope of the scriptures, it's fine. Like, chicken is considered a clean meat.
That's yeah, but they doing so much to it.
Yeah, see, that's why I said, what's your reason? And now, if your reason is all because of what they're doing to it,
it's the fact that they're causing it to be.
Man, but everything
they fakely making the meat.
Yeah, everything is a foul, like even certain vegetables.
Yeah, I was just going to say, even I used to eat nothing but lettuce and then pick string beans. But now it's like, I didn't play with the lettuce. I set the lettuce in the refrigerator for a week and it's still the same color.
Yeah,
so I went another week and it stayed the same color.
That ain't good.
Yeah, I ain't playing with it. Right. I stopped eating it.
I respect, you trying to do well. However, the scripture tells us that as much as hard as we want to try, somewhere along the line, the food's going to be good. But just saying, what food is going
to eat? I learned how to grow things when I was young. But the Boy Scouts, did a little bit of the military thing at school. And then I paid a lot of it.
But just long as I know everything you do, I would think some scriptures. Because when it comes to meat, you can say, well, the scripture says that chicken is lawful, you can eat it, but I recommend don't eat it because of what they do. Pork is like the number one thing according to the scriptures, that's unclean. Not supposed to
eat it.
So part of that, we'll say, look, you ain't supposed to eat this, it's not lawful. And then you can go into the how I said it. It won't even eat a damn pig. It won't even eat a damn pig.
Wow, I never
knew
that. I'm a little better. Y'all got a little sight on the internet or something?
I got the dietary law for you. Just see if you talk about it. I got a good sound. Better to read it.
Yeah, I mean, like I said, I got a reading problem, so it takes me.
I understand.
But I
didn't like reading before.
It ain't something that really never came to me, but I do. I got a memory. I remember any word. I can see it and know it, but I won't be able to spell it.
Well, I'm gonna tell you something. I like reading. That's why I read the scriptures and it's clear that this is our history, this is our heritage. It was like a different spark that went off. Love to read.
You do whatever necessary to get into it, right? To become better at it. Because if you're really passionate about something, and nothing can stop.
Yeah, I'm passionate about waking up my people.
Well,
that's
great.
You
got it.
Like you say, yeah.
Yeah, sure. This
is Deuteronomy 14:4, and it reads, these are the beasts which ye shall eat, the ox, the sheep, and the goat, and the... This is Deuteronomy 14:1. Ye are the children of the Lord, your power. You shall not cut yourselves, nor make any baldness between your eyes for the dead. I just go to the book.
Like
African,
somebody died with
Leviticus 11:1. And the Lord spake unto Moses and unto Aaron, saying unto them, speak unto the children of Israel, saying, these are the beasts which ye shall eat among all the beasts that are upon the earth. Whatsoever part of the hoof and is cloven footed and short the cud among the beasts, that shall ye eat.
And there's basically a whole list of what classifies that.
Verse 4, nevertheless, These shall ye not eat of them that chew the cud, but them that divide the hoof as the camel, because he chewed the cud but not biting the hoof. He is unclean to you. And the coney, because he chewed the cud but not biting the hoof, he is unclean to you. And the hare, because he chewed the cud but divided not the hoof, he is unclean to you. And the swine, though he divided the hoof and be cloven footed, yet he chewed not the cud, he is unclean to you.
On, but it gives you an idea. So all you need to do is make sure, okay, what's lawful and what's not. Which by now you can just look it up. Just type in Israel, Bible, lawful, unlawful. Really just an unlawful. It also goes on to make sure that tells you what you want to do.
Above a sound body and no joy above the joy of the heart.
Right, so it's talking about wisdom as far as having a sound body. So you take care of yourself, because truth be told, ask any elder, an older person, right? What matters most is their health. Let's say they did make it to retirement. Guess what? They can't walk. They can barely walk. They need a, you know what I'm saying? They can't stand that long. They'll tell you, with all this money, I'll do whatever it takes to be able to be a kid right now, to be able to run down the street. So the scriptures talk about how there's wisdom and
guidance.
Now, do we expect most people to go like cold turkey when it comes to smoking or anything like that? No, that's why we say, that's why I said, it help. And the fact that you're working on it, that's beautiful in itself, you know, because it's progress, then eventually.
Yeah, I had some addictions.
Hey, we all did. Look, all of us back here, we had some type of demon or something that was about to run out. And eventually we could get out of it. So we got that.
Also, we have people put the door open.
And you come up under the grace of the Lord, you protect the
right. That's what I had to do.
Isaiah 54, it says, no weapon shall prosper. No weapon that's formed against you shall prosper. So people throwing spells on you, and you under the wing of Yahweh Shema Shah, is the true name of the Lord, those spells not going to be
harmed. I know now. I keep hearing.
Yeah, because what it's going to do.
I don't have to worry about that no more because it's never protected.
Right, so like when they throw the spells at you, if you under the wing of the Lord, it's just gonna bounce back to you.
Yeah, if there's somebody in my vicinity that's under the influence or whatever, and then when they try to get on my nerves, I shoot that off.
All right,
when I get out of here,
I got one more.
Okay.
This is Hebrews chapter 5 and verse 12. It reads, for when for the time ye ought to be teachers, ye have need that one teach you again, which be the first principles of the oracles of the Most High, and are become such as have need of milk and not a strong meat.
When it's your time to be a teacher, you have need that one teach you again, so you gotta make sure you learn first. So you go out there, just like anybody that's gonna take a profession, when they send you out to school, they send you out to be a bad professional. They're not just going to say, all right, you start learning. They're going to show us what you mean. Okay, you understand this, you understand that, but you got to teach the students. So, it's about part of being born again is learning the book first. It's your basis. You got to take the book, you can't take the key. So, once you understand the basics, then that's how you grow. You got peace. Then that's when you're able to take the key. So, it's good that you're teaching others. You got to make sure it's also understand so that you can hit them with the scriptures. Because you can talk man's wisdom all day. You can tell you why that's not true. Because this pig, that, this, that. But you know where the power lies in? The Lord said that it's from the scriptures. That's what brings it home. Because people can debate what you think all day, but they can't debate what the Lord said. The Lord called it unclean. There's nothing that they can debate.
This is the book of Ephesians, chapter 4, and verse 20. The reason it says, but ye have not so learned Hamashiach, if so be that ye have heard him, and have been taught by him, as the truth is in Yahweh Shai, that ye put off concerning the former conversation of the old man, which is corrupt according to the deceitful lust, and be renewed in your spirit, of your mind, put on the new man, which is after Yahweh and created in righteousness and true holiness. So, coming to this truth, you gotta put off the old man. But you know, whatever you fight with, you come out of the ways of the Lord, the Lord will help you with that. Help you fight it through. Because when the Lord said, you know, the Lord tell you, he will fight for you.
Going back to the first question, what you asked is what could you contribute, right? So this is Matthew chapter 9, verse 37. It says, then he saith unto his disciples, the harvest truly is plenteous, but the laborers are few. Pray ye therefore the Lord of the harvest that he will send forth laborers into his harvest, right? So once you learn the truth and you learn the scriptures, and you know, you got that spirit to go out there and teach, that's one of the best things you can do, right? Is to get out there and teach, whether you join the camp or you go out there teaching by yourself.
Appreciate
that. All right,
man.
Y'all have a good one. All right, man.
Shalom. You too, Shalom. I'm going to pop up again one day.
Good.
Out here every Sunday.
Lord's will, we'll be out here every Sunday. All right. Oh.
But you see, like, you know, how we break bread at that point, that's how the Lord requires us. Especially part of the church, you know. His first question was, what can I do to help you? That's a beautiful request. Right? Up here, however, you know, nothing. You know, ask for anything. You know what I'm saying? We are here for you, actually. You know, if anything, we're saying, what can we do? Right? Give me the breakdown of this. But that shows you a good heart. And the Lord sees that. That could be part of the deal. You know? And it also depends who he walks up to, because the first thing, depending on who it is, if it's a wolf, right? The wolf may demand X, Y, and Z. But you ain't giving them what's in. You ain't giving them the name of the Lord, you ain't giving them. Here it is, you requesting and demanding from them, but you ain't giving them.
Ephesians chapter 5, starting at the 22nd verse, it says, "Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as unto the Lord Yahweh. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Mashiach is the head of the church, and he is the savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Mashiach, let the wives be to their own husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, even as Mashiach also loved the church and gave himself for it, that he may sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word, that he might present it to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish."
You see, first of all, again, that goes back to the order. I got a wife that believes such and such. Speak to her, show her role that she can play. It's just that simple. You got to remember, this is about the church. So there's order in the church. So if you call yourself a believer, then that means you're part of the church. So Yahweh Shah is trying to present this church without spot or wrinkle. Because when you have spots and wrinkles, that's a problem. It's just like if you have an all-white suit, whatever the case is, you got one or two spots. And it takes away from the whole purity, because everything's going to be narrowed down to that one spot. Those are like blemishes and all that. That takes away from the glory. I want to make sure that his church is on point. So you see, it goes back to us having the responsibility. And that goes into order. So if we just read the order about man and woman, we can't have a church where the woman is above the man. That's out of order. And that's the Lord doesn't like that. From the teachers, we gotta make sure we're on the same line, we teach the same thing. That's the difference between what we need. But until that time, really be in the kingdom.
We got to be over here.
Y'all brothers over here. Y'all brothers do y'all thing. And we got to the point now where we're not going to approach because we already know what it's going to come down to. Because of what we just saw was a complete display of disorder dealing with the IUIC and the IUIC. All it took was for one of them to apply the order, and it all could have been squashed. All right. But that's a blot. That's a blot on the church, you could say. Really on their church, okay? Because they didn't apply the scripture. That's going to be the question. Why didn't the leader group, since they know so much, why didn't neither one of them apply the scripture?
Yeah, especially the IURC podcast.
Keep the commandments.
shit. Love that neighbor as thyself. Alright, you watch the video, and they get, you know, they basically antagonizing I ain't sugar case. Okay? Going, pour the cooler and stuff. You know, facing the speakers over. And then, you know, like going into their space and shit. You know, we all had a nigga that do it like that. Nigga trying to bump into you and stuff. You know, they try to start some shit. This nigga shit.
Alright. I better hope that the police don't ask for the video and see that you, that the IUIC started the fight. They're gonna go based on who was the first punch or the first blow. It's technically you assaulted that man. So it's like, you know, don't get mad if one of that man that pushed that IACBK man would get charged with assault, man.
Both of them got 501c3s.
Both paid off and acting like that, man.
Luckily, nobody went to jail. And that's just an embarrassment. You didn't have to call it yourself. You really didn't. The best dude was three men. Okay. And I could have just said, look, we're going our separate ways. Let get off of it and let him go. He had to call it. But nevertheless, it happened. So, this is going, I guess you could say the top